Hello everyone, welcome to Nick IT Academy. In this session, we will see how to install Informatica PowerCenter 10.2 or 10.4 in our Windows machine. In order to install Informatica PowerCenter, we have to follow these 9 steps for the complete installation. First, we have to download the necessary softwares like Oracle 11G and Informatica 10.2 and Oracle SQL Developer. So either from Oracle eDelivery site, or you can download it from the given link, the description. And then once download completes, you extract all the software by using either WinRAR or WinZip. Extract it will take some time. So once extract has been completed, so install Oracle 11G first. So why we are installing this Oracle 11G? So this is the Informatica repository we are going to create, as well as we are going to make it as the source and target. And configure SQL Developer to query the database. So once the database has been installed, you can start installing Informatica PowerCenter server. So Informatica server can be installed on top of any of the database. So that is the reason we have installed Oracle 11G. This Informatica 10.2 is compatible with 11G software. That is why we are installing 11G. So install Informatica PowerCenter server first, then configure the repository and integration service in the admin console. Then install Informatica client, configure the source and target connections, create a test mapping and execute it successfully. So these are all the 9 steps we have to follow. So you can download the software from the link from the description, or you can download the latest version. You can go to this particular site and install and download the 11G Express Edition for 64-bit OS, then download it. So once downloaded, you can unzip it. So it will be, once you have downloaded, it will be like this. So you can unzip it. So this is what Oracle XE 64-bit. I have given in the link, you download it and extract it by using the WinRAR. So if you don't have WinRAR, go to Google and type WinRAR. So WinRAR download, and go here and download. Click on this blue color icon. So download WinRAR. Continue download. So it will be downloaded here. So once downloaded, click on exe file, then WinRAR will be available in your machine. Then after WinRAR, you can right click on this zip file. You can click on extract to Oracle XE, this option, okay, third option. Then it will be extracted like this. So you have to, first you have to extract, then you have to download the Informatica server. For the Informatica server download, you can go to Oracle eDelivery site. So type Oracle eDelivery. You go to this particular site, https://edelivery.oracle.com. You can first, you can sign in. If you don't have any account, you create the account and then sign in. So I will sign in with my credential. So once you have signed in, so you'll be getting like this, the first page. You type here. So Informatica PowerCenter. So you type Informatica PowerCenter. Okay, then you'll be getting, just a click on the second one, Oracle Business Intelligence Data Warehouse. You can click on this particular link. So it will be added to the view items. So click on view items here, continue. So this is the page you will get it. The platform or languages. So you choose whatever the OS you have. You can choose the Linux or Windows or any, whatever the platform you have, you can download that particular version. Has been, the platform has been selected. You can click on continue. So accept the policy. You can go to the below one. You can accept the policy here. Click on continue. So you will get some survey. You can close the survey and it will be having all the softwares here. So you can uncheck this and then you can choose 10.2 or 10.4 version, whatever the version you want. Okay. For example, 10.2, it has 2 zip files. One is 1 of 2, 2 of 2. You have to click on this. If you want 10.4, so you can choose these two. So click on this link. Okay, click on this link. It will get downloaded. You can click on the second link. It will get automatically downloaded. Okay. So once download has been completed, so it will be like this. So you can unzip all the file, extract to Informatica. The same way client also you can unzip it. So it will be like this. Once unzip, the file will be like this. Okay. So we have downloaded the software. The Oracle 11G we have downloaded. Informatica software we have downloaded. So you can download Oracle SQL Developer. So you can type Oracle SQL Developer So you can go to this particular link. So here also you can download the Windows 64-bit JDK. So you can download this one. So this is a Java JDK included with SQL Developer. So why are we downloading this SQL Developer? I will tell you, this is the front end tool. So you have to sign in. So once sign in, it will automatically get downloaded. So once it has downloaded, it will be available like this. So SQL Developer, you can unzip it again. So this is also you can unzip. So that file will be unzipped. So we have downloaded the Oracle software, SQL Developer, and Informatica software. We have completed the download and extract. Now we will go with the Oracle 11g installation. So before going to install Oracle 11g, we will see the setup. Okay, consider this is the Oracle 11g software. This is a database we have. So once you have installed the software, it has inbuilt. The user is called a system. Okay, inbuilt user is called a system. That is a schema we have. And inbuilt, we have one more schema called HR. So this schema we will create here. And we will create one more schema for our Informatica repository. So that schema, we will call it as Infa. Infa user we will create. And we will create one more schema for the target. Okay, so we will keep. So this database for source and target. So this is the system schema. Infa schema for Informatica repository, HR schema for source, and core schema for target. We don't have any other database here. So that is the reason we are going to use source and target on the same database. If you have any other database, you can make Oracle 11g as the source and SQL Server or DB2 or Teradata are the target database. Okay, so in system schema, we have metadata tables. All the Oracle metadata tables will be there. So you can see here Oracle metadata tables will be there. So this is the metadata tables. So here we do have metadata is nothing but all the dictionary tables will be there. Metadata tables, dictionary tables available in the system schema. And infa schema, so we are going to create the schema for, schema is nothing but subset of our database. For the easy access and privileges, we are creating the multiple schemas. So Informatica schema, we are going to use it for Informatica repository. So we are going to create Informatica repository to hold Informatica related metadata tables. So then we have the source and target. This HR schema, we are going to make it as source. And this core schema, we are going to make it as a target. Through Informatica, we are going to pull the data from HR schema tables to core schema tables. So this is the Informatica tool we are bringing here. In HR schema, we do have, so here we have the tables like employees, locations, departments, lot of tables are there, okay, departments. Here you can create any tables like T underscore employees, like target employees. You can create a customer table. You can create any tables here. So product table, any tables you can create. So we are going to make this schema tables as source, this schema tables as target. So through Informatica, we are going to load it. So why do we need this infa schema? To have Informatica metadata repository. So this is the rep we are going to create it here. So Informatica repository we are going to create. So in this particular schema. So that is the reason we have created the infa schema. By default, system schema and HR schema will be available. This Informatica's infa schema and core schema we will create it. So in order to query this database, we are going to have the tool called SQL Developer. So SQL Developer is an application development tool. So this tool we are going to, so we have downloaded already. So you can download, if not a download, you can download. So first we have to install Oracle software. Then we have to configure this SQL Developer. From SQL Developer, we have to give the connections. You can query this database. So that this is SQL Developer, just an interfacing tool, GUI tool, graphical user interface. So what data is available on the database, we can query from the SQL Developer. Okay, first we will install the Oracle 11g. Go to this extracted file, double click on this disk one, double click on the setup file, click on yes here. So it will take some time to click on next here, accept the policy, click on next. We have to provide the password for this system user. The username is system rsys. The password I'm going to give us admin. So you can give the same password or your own password, but you have to remember this password in order to create any other schema or unlocking the users, we have to remember this password. So username is system, the password is admin. So click on install here. It will take some time to install. So the username for this particular schema, the system schema is, username is system, the password is admin. So by using this username and password, you can create n number of schema in the database, and you can see what data is available on the other schema tables. So once Oracle has been installed, you will be getting this finish button. So click on finish. So now we have done with the third step. So installation has been completed. Now we will go to the configure SQL developer to query this database. This is the configuration we will do. Go to this SQL developer, whatever we have already extracted. So I have extracted and kept it here. So double click on it. Go to this particular file. Go to this SQL developer. Double click on it. Then SQL developer will be opened. So it will take. So first of all, if you are doing very first time, it may ask questions like, do you want to import all the preference? So you can give no. So this is the front page of the SQL developer. So from SQL developer, we are going to connect the Oracle, the database which we have installed. So click on this plus symbol to create the connection. So it will ask the connection name. We can give the connection name as admin. Username is system. Password is admin, which we have given while installing the software. So localhost, port number will be 1521 and SID will be XE. So this is the default port number and everything. So you can click on test. It should be succeeded now. Success. Click on connect. Then admin will be connected and it will open this workspace here. So you can unlock this HR schema. Initially, the HR schema will be on locked state. If you look at here, you can click on HR schema. You can go here. You can check HR and password as HR. It will be on locked state. Okay, the account is locked. We will unlock it. How to unlock? How to use alter user, username identified by password, that is HR, account unlock. I have given these script, these queries in the description. You can take it. And you can either you can click on this green color icon or control enter. So control enter, it will the shortcut for executing this particular statement. So user HR has been altered now. The same way you can create the user. We will create one user for infra, one user for the core schema. Create user, username as infra, identified by infra. So create the user. User has been created. Then provide the permission, grant. So we can grant the DBA permission, grant DBA to infra user. So we are, since we have created this user, we are granting the permission, DBA permission. From admin schema only, you can able to give this permission, no other schema. Create one more user, create user core identified by core, semicolon, control enter, semicolon terminates the particular line of code. So I can give grant connect comma resource to core. This is one more permission. So I'm giving the basic permission to this particular core schema. So we have created core schema and infra schema. Already HR schema is available. We have unlocked it. If you click on the plus symbol, you can connect to the HR schema. Username will be HR, password will be HR. Test it. Now it will be tested. Click on connect. Now go to plus symbol, go to infra schema. So user is infra. So this is for repository creation. Test it, it will be connected, connect. And again, you can go for plus symbol. You can go to the one more schema called core schema. This is for, we are going to make it as a target. Core, contest, it will be connected. So now we have connected everything. So if you go to the HR schema, you can see the table like select star from employees table. You have list of tables. If you want to check the table list, you can go here. You can see the tables here. So since the core schema we have created, nothing will be there in the table list. We can create it. So I'm going to create a table in core schema by using admin schema. By using admin schema, we can create a table in core schema. So I'm going to create shortcut, create table, table name, core.t_employees. So I am creating this employees table. So I'm going to make this as a target table. So I'm going to make this, so this is the target table, t_employees, and employees the source table. I'm going to make this as a source and target. I'm going to load it. So I'm going to create one empty table in target core schema. So create table, table name as select star from hr.employees, where 1 = 2, where 1 = 2, nothing but. So this particular statement will not fetch any data. 1 will not be equal to 2. So it will fetch that structure. I'm creating one structure. So now if you go here in the core schema, you can see select star from the table t_employees, the table will be there. So we have created, we have the employees table, and we have created one more table t_employees. So we are going to fetch the table data from this employees and load it into t_employees through Informatica. So for this, we are going to install Informatica server now. So we can go to the Informatica server. So once we have extracted, it will be available like this. All the file you can extract, I have given this up, this extracted file in the link, you can download it from here. So double click on this install. So double click on this install button. It will ask yes or no, click yes. Okay, so click on yes here. It will prepare to install. It will take some time. So you can see one, I have given in the description one, the key. So we have to keep the key here, key also. So this is the key file. So this will not get expired. You can use it for any number of days. It will not get expired. So it's a free key, which is available in the Oracle eDelivery itself. You can use it for academic purpose. So you can go here. This is what the page you will be getting it. So you can see install Informatica 10.2. You can agree the policy. Click on next. You can click on next here. You can choose the license key. Click on these three dots. Choose that particular file. I have given this file in the description. You can download it. Click on open. And you can go to the next. You can click on install. So it will get installed. It will take some time. Even it may take 15 to 20 minutes, or even it may take more than that. It depends on your system speed. Once 100% completed, you'll be getting this particular window. You can click on next. No need to give anything here. You can click on next. Allow access. Provide allow access. Then here we have to give the repository details. So we have created for repository, for we have created the infa schema, right? So that schema we will provide. So database user ID will be infa. The password will be infa. So INFA. Host name will be local host without space. Port number will be 1521. Service name will be XE. So this should be like this. So local host 1521. Service name will be XE. Express edition. So then you have to click on, you have to test it. So click on test connection. The connection should be successful. Click on OK. Next. Here you can give the encryption password as administrator@1. Okay, so you can give any password, but we have to remember this password. So I'm giving like the encryption password as administrator@1. You can copy and paste it. Click on next. Click on OK. Here it will ask you to enter the domain username and password. So I'm entering the username as admin. So this is the Informatica username. The username is administrator. The password also same, administrator. So this is the Informatica username and password, domain username and domain password. So this is what I'm entering. So domain password will be administrator. You have to type it. You cannot copy. You have to type it. Administrator. Administrator. So here, so one important thing, you have to uncheck this option, configure the model repository, right? So uncheck this option. We will create the repository in admin console. No need to create any model repository here. You uncheck this option, okay? Configure the model repository. Don't forget to uncheck it. Uncheck this option. Click on next. It will take some time. So once this page is loaded, you can uncheck this run Informatica under a different user and click on next. So we will use the administrator user. It will take some time again, and then it will get installed. It will take Informatica, it will run the Informatica services, and it will take around 5 to 10 minutes. So server installation has been completed. You can see the status, installation status success, and installation is complete. Now, we have done all the five steps. So now we will configure this repository and integration service. So I will create one repository and integration service. Go to this particular, so you have the link. So click on this particular link. Click on this link. It will open the Informatica admin console page. You'll be getting this, since it is a HTTPS, you'll be getting this particular error. So you have to click on advanced. So proceed to desktop. You can click on this. Then you'll be getting this administrator page. So username will be administrator, A caps. So administrator. And password will be the same. So you can copy and paste it. Administrator. So that is what we have given while installing. So click on login. So this is the admin console page. You can create repository and integration service by clicking on this service and notes. So click on services and notes. You'll be getting this particular page. The domain will be domain. And right click on the domain. Go to new. Create new repository service. First, we will create a repository to hold all your Informatica metadata tables. So you can click on this repository. You can provide a rep is the repository service and click on license. You choose the license in the dropdown, the node, click on next. So database type should be Oracle. So that is what we have created. So username will be info. So this is a repository username and password we have already created. So info and XE, Express Edition. So no need to do anything on this code page and all. So you can click on no content exist. This option you can click on finish. Then it will create repository service. The repository services should be available. So the operating mode, it should be normal mode. If it is exclusive, then click on this edit repository properties. You can choose this operating mode as normal. Click on OK. OK here. And it will restart again. The repository will restart. Again, it should be available. So it should be operating mode should be normal. So we have successfully created repository service. Now again, click on the domain. Go to right click, new integration service. So integration service, you can give us IS. So choose a license again, node. Click on next. You choose a repository as rep. And username will be administrator. You can copy and paste. Password will be administrator for the repository. Click on finish. Click on OK here. So the service will be first initially it will be disabled. You can see here right side. Click on enable the service. It will be enabled. So you can enable the service now. So it should be service should be available. So both repository and integration service. Both should be available, then only you can connect the Informatica server. So we have done with the sixth step. We will go to the Informatica client, we will install, then we will configure the source and target connection, we will create on mapping. So next one, we are going to install the Informatica client. So I have given already the Informatica client, you can download. You can go to the client here, one more client folder, then double click on the install button, this particular application. So click on yes. So it will take some time. So the server, you can click on done. It is taking the client is installing now. So in this page, you can click on next. We are freshly installing the software client. Click on next. So here you can choose PowerCenter client. Click on next. Click on next. Install it. So again, it will take some time. So around it will take 5 to 10 minutes. So once installation complete, you can click on done button. And then we have completed 7 steps. We can open the Informatica client and then we will configure the source and target. Open repository manager. So type repository manager. So it will open Informatica Repository Manager. So first we will create the repository. Go click on repository, select repository here. Go to repository, add repository. So repository name you can give rep, and username will be administrator. Click on OK. Right click, click on configure domain. Click on the plus symbol here. Add a new domain. So domain name will be domain only. So this is what we have, domain name here. So if you have any other name here, you can use that name. So but here domain name will be domain only. So you can use domain. Gateway host will be local host, and port number will be 6005. For Informatica, the gateway port number is 6005. For Oracle, the gateway port number will be 1521. Click on OK. So here rep should be available here. So that means you have configured very correctly. Click on OK. Right click, go to connect now. So it should be available. The security domain should be available as native. You can provide the username as administrator and password also administrator. Click on connect. So it will be connected now. So here in repository manager, we used to create only folder. You can go to the folder here, create a folder. So I'm creating folder as training folder. Click on OK now. The folder has been successfully created. Can open. So this is what we will create in repository manager. Go to designer. You can click on the designer. Click on OK. So whatever the folder we have created in repository manager, that will be available here. Right click on the training folder. You have to open it. So if you open, then here the workspace will be opened. I have explained the Informatica client tool in other videos. You can watch that video. Now we will configure the source. The source will be HR schema employees table, as I have explained. So I will go to the source, import from database. You have to create a source connection. Go here. So click on this three dot, go to add, click on add. So our source is Oracle. So we will choose the driver as Oracle Wire Protocol, finish. So the source name we can give as Oracle underscore SRC. And then the host name will be local host. So this is your Oracle details. We are making that HR schema source. Port number will be 1521 and the service name will be XE. You can click on apply and click on OK. The same way we will create one more connection for target or core schema. You can use the same connection, but we will create separately to avoid the confusion here. So host. Can click here, local host, port number will be 1521 and can provide the XE. So you may ask question. So you have given both are same, right? Why we are creating two? So here we will differentiate. We will choose source connection for source. So you can give the source connection. Username is HR. Tab, automatically the owner name. Owner name is nothing but it's a schema name. It will automatically populate. Password will be HR. So this HR and this HR should be the lowercase, whatever you have given. So here we have given, right? So this is the username and password we have to make over here. So click on OK, connect. So it will bring all the tables and views here. So either you can take tables or the views. So I can take employees table, click on OK. Now the Informatica will bring the structure of the Oracle table. So if you look at here, it is showing employees Oracle. So all the column names, this is primary key, this is foreign key within the same table. It's like a self join. So can go to the target again, target designer. So we have done with source. We'll go to the target. So click on target, import from database. Why? Because target also database. Can click on target connection. So core. Tab and again password as core, click on connect. Since we have created one table by using admin schema, we have created one table, right? So this is the way we have created. So that table will be available. So you can have this table. So as of now, we don't have any data. So nothing is there. So you can click on OK. So this target also has been loaded, imported. So you can go to the third one is mapping designer. Click on mapping. Create M underscore So test mapping. So I can make it like test mapping. So you can see my other videos to have all the Informatica training materials and the training videos. So now you can drag and drop the employees table. So whenever you are drag and drop the source qualifier will be imported. And you can drag and drop the target here, right hand side. So source should be on the left hand side, target will be on the right hand side. Right click, select all, drag and drop the, so keep the cursor here on the head. So I can drag and drop here. So everything will be mapped correctly. So control S, it should be valid now. So your mapping should be valid now. If you look at here, the below, it should be valid. If it is not valid, you have to check the log and then you have to find why it is not valid, but it is valid now. So we will go to the workflow manager. So we have done source, target and mapping. We will go to the workflow manager, open the workflow manager, click on this W icon from there. The workflow manager will be opened automatically. So here click on OK. So here also we have to create the connection. Go to connection here. So click on relational connection. So since your source is Oracle, so you can click on new. So source, we will create Oracle connection. So Oracle underscore SRC. So by using this connection only, Informatica will connect. So username and password and connection string. So in our other videos, you can find without the hard coding, the connection value I have provided with the parameterized connection value, that you can check it. So how to provide a parameterized connection value. So first I'm creating a connection here. Click on one more connection for target. Target also we are having it in the same Oracle database on the different schema. So schema name will be core, password will be core, connection name will be XE. Click on OK now, close it. We have created the connection. This is one time activity. Go to workflow, the workflow designer. Click on workflow designer here. Click on workflow designer. So these two are reusable component. So I have explained task developer and workflow designer in some other videos. You can check it. Click on workflow designer, go to workflows, create. So WEF underscore test mapping. Okay. So you can use test mapping, test workflow or anything. So here we have created that start button. It will be there. Click on this icon, session icon. Okay. So here we have the icon, right? Click on session icon. So one click here. So mapping will be available. Can click on okay. So click on this link task. So click on the start button, mouse, and then drag and drop. So you can create the link task. Now double click on the test mapping. Go to mapping here, the tab, provide the source and target connection. Source should be reader. So source always reader, relational reader. So this is a connection. Target also pointing to same, right? So you have to provide the target connection. If it is pointing to SRC, then it will go and check the table in HR schema. So since we have created target in T underscore employees in core schema, we have to point to this particular connection, TGT. Okay, then we have to, if you want, you can provide truncate target table. Before loading the table, it will truncate and load. Control S, the workflow also should be valid. Now right click on the workspace, the white space, right click on anywhere in the white space, click on start workflow. The workflow monitor will automatically open here. So this is the four client tool which is available. So it's showing as running, got succeeded. You can click on the task view button. You can select your workflow. You can see here, you can close this log and you can open this source and target statistics. You can see here 107 record read from the source and written into the target. So you don't have any rejected rows. If you want, you can check the session log by right click, get session log. You can check the session log. If any error, so you can press E here, you can check the error and then you can find. This is what, if you go and check now, in the target schema, it has been loaded now. This is what complete installation of Informatica. Now, Informatica, everything is ready. You can practice by seeing my other videos, you can practice it. Okay, so once everything done, most of the student will ask, how can I close it? Right click on the REP rep, you can disconnect properly. It will be disconnected. If you want any other folder, you can create it after some time. You can properly disconnect. You can properly disconnect and it will be disconnect and then it will be. Don't keep the client tool more than 15 minutes. So it will get disconnected. Then again, it may lead to some other issues. So you may ask question tomorrow, how can I open? I have given this particular script, SQL queries, in the description. You can copy from there. So you have to make sure that which schema you are running. So admin schema, HR schema, infra schema, and core schema. No need to open infra again. So leave it. You can open HR and core next time. Can close it. How can I open next time? So you can ask the question now. Next time, so you have to, so wherever you have the SQL developer, wherever you have the SQL developer, you can go to this SQL developer. You can double click on it, or you can make it to shortcut to desktop. It will create one shortcut. Okay. So from there you can open. Just double click on it. It will be opened. Click on this HR schema. So just click on the plus symbol HR. Click on OK. It will open here. The workspace will be open here. And click on the core schema. You can click on the provide the password as core. Then both will open here. So HR and core has been opened now. So you can create n number of tables here. You can access it. You can make HR as core. HR as source and core as target. You can do a lot of mapping. Go to this service. Okay, services. So or you can type just simply services here. You can go to service. You can check whether Informatica service is up and running. It should be running, then only your Informatica will open. Informatica client will connect. Otherwise, it will not connect. So if it is not running, you start the Informatica service, wait for 10 minutes. Okay, at least you wait for 5 to 10 minutes. After that, you try to connect this client. Okay, after that, you try to connect this designer. So then only it will connect. While you are trying to connect it, you should be getting this particular connect to repository. This window you should get it. Otherwise, your service is not up and running. Why? Because in real time, the Informatica server is up and running 24/7. But here, since we have shut down our machine, it may shut down. You have given the startup type is automatic, but sometime it will not be automatically, it will not start it. So you have to start manually, like right click, start here. So wait for 10 minutes and then you can connect to the Informatica, start learning. Kindly subscribe to my channel. I have put a lot of effort to create this particular video. So kindly subscribe and click on bell button and support me watching the other videos. Thank you for watching. So I will upload Informatica training videos as many as possible. If you are facing any issues on the installation, you can post it on the comment. Or you can send the screenshot to my mail ID. So this is what the mail ID, nicitacademy@gmail.com. So you can send your queries to this particular mail ID. I will answer all your queries. Thanks for watching. Keep learning. Thank you very much.